Okay, Dave here. Just pulled this old high-end Sony unit out of the storage area. And I don't know if you notice over here, but there is no video. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is just demonstrate the best way, maybe not the best way, but the way to clean the video head. Now you see that? There's the video head spinning there. The camera probably can't get a good focus on it because it's a spinning object. I don't know, maybe not. But anyways, in order to clean that, what I usually do is just put my finger right here and kind of, it'll screw up the audio a little bit, but, oh, we got a different tones here. But we should be able to get the image back here. No, guess what? She ain't gonna clean up real easy. I wonder if maybe my cable is screwed here. Could be I don't have the cable plugged in. I'm not sure. No, the cable's plugged in. That's a good one. So I'm going to have to use the real video cassette cleaning head. But anyways, there's the inside of this really old high-end VCR. It's a Sony. So I'm just going to eject this tape and go get my head cleaning tape. Thanks for watching. I don't know if you noticed that at the end, but the tape got caught on the capstan roller, and if you just watch this little arm here, you'll notice that it is moving very slowly. Okay, that's because on a Sony the little pivot point here gets dirty after a while, and it gums up with lubricant, and that's what's actually catching the tape. These things here don't really have belts, pretty well all direct drive, so that's about the only thing that causes the tape to get eaten in a Sony. So what you want to do is take this unit apart right here and lubricate that. You'll see it'll move really, really, really slow. Anyways, I'm gonna go get my head cleaning tape and I'll be back in 2 seconds. There we go, we got the head cleaning tape, and as you can see, that's pretty well back into the home position there now. So I just got to put this tape in, and you'll see it'll grab the tape alright. But so now what you want to do is put it on record. So I got to find the record button here. Okay, there's record, away it goes. So we'll let it record for about 10 seconds there. And this is supposedly the ideal way to clean the video head, which is here. And this is the audio head as well. This is the tracking head here. And let's just see when we eject this tape whether it'll get that, if that arm's going to snag up the tape again. If you watch it very carefully. Matter of fact, I'm going to zoom in on it. And you'll see what I'm talking about. Right now the arm is right underneath this hole in the metal, right below here. I'll just point to it with a pencil. Right below this point right here, you can see it down underneath there. So when I push stop, you'll see, and eject, you'll see that that arm travels really slow, and that's what's hanging the tape up. See, watch, see that? Oh no, it cleared out of the way this time. So no sense showing you that, I guess. Anyways, I'm going to put the tape, the real tape back in there. And we'll see if that, in fact, has cleaned the head. I'm hoping we'll get an image here. Still no image. So, I'm going to try cleaning the head again this way. At the same time, I'm actually watching the image on the TV screen here to know whether or not. Well, this is a stubborn one. The head cleaner doesn't really do anything. Doesn't seem to fix the picture. Oh, we're getting a little closer. We're getting some image now when I go on to fast forward. So I'm just gonna try a little more here. Still hasn't fixed it. I'm just going to pause it and see if possibly. Nope, still no image. So it's slowly coming back. We're getting a little bit of an image right now on the TV set. As you'll see here. See that? So I'm just going to clean it some more here. She's coming back. Wow, that's a tuppy. Okay. So we'll stop this, eject it, and try again. Okay, whoops, sorry. Still getting no image. So I'm just going to put her on high speed rewind. Super fast rewind. Now this is a really good VCR because it has like a 6 or 7 head video drum, so it's worth resurrecting, but look at how fast that baby's going. Now it's going to go back into a regular speed rewind. Hit play. We still got no image. That's a good one. Oh, I see what's going on. The tape has actually missed this pickup totally here. You see that? It's actually not even riding on that side. It's just coming out of the cassette. So that's the problem with this. It's not loading correctly. So we'll get this out of here. Ah, see? This isn't going all the way back home. So the cam underneath is screwed. That's what's wrong with this. There's a cam directly underneath this that's not taking this back home where it should. So I'm just going to put the tape back in again. Hit stop. And I'm going to manually thread this tape. Hopefully it doesn't get eaten up. Oh, it's probably going to get eaten up, so I can't really do that. That's the reason why the tape's not going around that arm. Yeah, man. This should be back here like this. See? I'm not sure why, but something, the cam on the bottom must be out of position. So, let me just confirm that by holding this down. Put the tape in. Now it'll load properly, see? Now we'll be able to get an image on there. See that? Perfect. So yeah, that's what needs to be fixed on this one. And look at the pause on this puppy. You hit pause and look at that. Frame by frame action. Pretty good, eh? Speed it up a little. We're back to full speed. So there, that's what's wrong with this. Is that one arm is not going into the right position. So I'll have to fix that. Probably got dislodged in the move somehow. So there you go. Maybe I'll make a video on how to repair that. Thanks for watching. Okay, so in order to get at that cam, I need to remove the bottom cover here. Yeah, buddy, chooch it. Okay. Well, looks like you got to take these out completely to get that off. So we'll pop all these screws out. If I remember correctly, there's a board in the bottom of this that covers the mechanism totally, so it might be a little difficult to get this cam repositioned again. We'll certainly see any second now here. No, I haven't unplugged this from the wall, so the power is still on. And yep, it'd be one of these two little cams in underneath here is in the wrong spot. So I'm going to have to pull this board up, which involves removing these screws, the black headed screws, turning the power off first, disconnecting those two wires there, and then repositioning that cam. So I'll just unplug it here. Give her a whirl. Did I ever tell you how much I dislike fixing VCRs? They are fairly simple to repair. Okay. Just have a quick peek underneath here without unplugging the connectors. Sometimes, yeah, this one is completely severed. The cam is completely shattered in half because of the spring inside it. So I'll just give you a quick look at that. And this is going to be pretty well a write-off, this VCR, unless I got another one of those sitting around somewhere. But right in here are these connectors. You just sort of give them a little pull out. It's a little hard to do upside down, but get your finger in like this, kind of pop up. Two of them just pop out like that. And you'll see the cam is completely split in half. It's kind of a strange setup where they put a steel spring inside. Okay, you see how that's completely split. Let's get back in here better with the camera and show you. See that? See how they say a cam has completely split? That's the reason why that arm isn't in the right position. So this is going to be a total write-off, this VCR. Yep, see, look at that. It's completely demoed. And it's mainly because of this heavy-duty spring right here. And I'm certainly not going to write to Sony to try and get a cam for this really old VCR. I wish I had one of these mechanisms sitting around, but I don't. So there you go. This is a write-off, this one.